You're watching Street Vibes. I'm Anthony Thomas. Today, the people speak into an open mic. Let us hear what they have to say. I know they have enough to supply you with thoughts. Let us go to them.
My concern has to do with the state of roads in St. Lucia. Even in the city, we have a number of places where almost impassable, even on foot, far less to drive there. So I think whichever ministry, because right now it should be infrastructure, do something about the state of the roads, because that too is causing a lot of problems for the government, because some people are going to take action against government when their vehicles get jammed. So I think that is my concern, the state of the roads in St. Lucia.
Because on Jeremy Street there, they have a double parking there. They mounted the bus on the other side of the road. Sometimes now, if it's an emergency, sometimes now, you know, up there, like a fire catching one of those buildings there. The fire engine cannot reach there. It can't reach there at all. So right now, then the police and them now right now, then have to see, like on a regular basis, like to check on that man. I mean, it's a hazard.
One of the things that's really affecting me is the level of support for local initiatives. I believe a lot should be done, a lot more should be done for support of upcoming NGOs when it comes to youth initiatives and most of the initiatives that are being done in the community. That's what's affecting me today.
What I have to say, I see a lot of parking meters around the place. I think the government, the CDC, who are in charge of the city, should have extra educated solutions about parking meters, particularly a lot of drivers. Some of our drivers are uneducated, and the public. We want to know how the parking meters and what day the parking meters will be opening. That's all I have to say.
I spoke some time ago concerning the service we're getting from the Denry bus drivers, but I must say it's better now, but more can still be done. You know, there can be more, there can be improvements. And I also want to address the passengers, those who are going on the bus to go down to Denry. Sometimes it's frustrating, the buses are there and they refuse to load the bus for the bus to go. Sometimes the bus only missing two persons, one person, and the bus have to spend 1 hour, half an hour to just get that one person, and that is frustrating for the bus drivers. So that is why you see when you see it's raining or when you see it's after five, when they go, they don't want to come back. And I don't blame them for that, because when the bus is there, they give the buses a hard time. So I think I'm appealing to the passengers, when the buses are there and it's pulling, go on the bus, pull the bus, let the bus leave and for another bus to pull, so that we could get good service from the Denry bus drivers.
Hi, good afternoon, my St. Lucian people. Hope everyone is doing well in spite of, you know, the difficulties along the way. I just want to take the opportunity first and foremost to extend sympathy to the Daniel family of Sans Souci, John Daniel, and the rest of the family who lost their mom. And I wish them strength and comfort at this time, and all other families mourning the loss of a loved one. I want to also talk to you about a pageant, the 50 plus pageant, that's taking place at the Cultural Center on Sunday at 2:30. So come and see six beautiful ladies display their talents, all in support of the National Council of and for Older Persons.
You have heard what the people had to say. You said it all. We were in East Twins. And now I take you back to the studio.